I'm Kim and this is my December wrap-up slash reading story video. I decided to not only do a December wrap-up, but also a reading story instead of a 2016 wrap-up thing, kind of, because I haven't read a lot in the past couple of years and I'm intending to change that, or I already did change it starting with December or even beginning of November. Since I'm also starting this channel now, I decided to combine my December wrap-up and as well as my reading story to give you kind of an overview as to what kind of books I'm reading, what kind of books I want to read, what kind of books I have read, and just to get you guys to know me a little better. I'm sorry if the lighting keeps changing. I'm filming with natural light and the sun is kind of hiding sometimes and then coming out big time other times, so I'm hopeful that the sunshine, as you can see it right now, will last a little bit longer and we can kind of get through this video with decent lighting. I'm really, really hopeful today, okay? So for my reading story, I'm going to start with my preteens. Now you might think this is going to be a huge video, but it isn't actually, because I've kind of dropped off the bandwagon when it came to reading a couple of years ago. So yeah, there isn't so much to tell, but let's just get started. As I said, I'm gonna start with my preteens, and in my preteens I mainly read fantasy. I don't really remember a lot of books. There are only two books or two series worth mentioning. The first one is the Artemis Fowl series by Ian Colfer, which I remember I've read all the books and I really love them. I'm not exactly sure what happened in each one right now, so I really want to reread them. But yeah, that's just something I decided to mention because I have a lot of fond memories of this series. The other thing, of course, is Harry Potter. I started reading Harry Potter when I was in fourth grade, or our teacher started reading the first Harry Potter book to us when I was in fourth grade. So from then on out, I always read all the books. I waited for the new releases. I reread the old releases. I listened to them on audiobook time and time again. So Harry Potter is a big thing for me, as it is probably for most of us in this booktube community. But as for my teens, I didn't read YA, like, at all. I didn't even really know about YA. I went straight from my preteen years to adult books, and yeah, that's what I read up until I was like 20. In this time I read a lot of Tom Clancy, for example, or Ken Follett. Barbara Wood is an author I remember, and just in general I mainly read thrillers as well as historical fiction. And then when I was around 20, I made a mistake. I discovered Harry Potter fanfiction, and from then on out, up until like this year, I'm 25 now, by the way. So for the last 5 years, I pretty much didn't read anything other than Harry Potter fanfiction. Of course, at the beginning, it was kind of a transition period where I read my regular books as well as Harry Potter. But about half a year later or something, I was hooked on fanfiction and I didn't read anything else. The only book series I read during that time, which was, I think, pretty much at the beginning of the time, was the Twilight series. It was those, the Twilight series, so don't be surprised if you do not recognize those books. They're the German editions. They're my sister's, actually, because I read my sister's, so I don't have them on my own, and I didn't read them on ebook, which is what I read mostly now. But my sister got them, and she was really excited about them, so I decided to read them as well. I also listened to audiobooks during the time, but only there was only one series I listened to, and it was the whole Jack Ryan, John Clark series or universe by Tom Clancy. Or not the whole, because there were, I think, two books that came out in 2016. I don't think I've read or listened to them yet, but up until that point I've listened to all of them. Nothing else. Up until the beginning of 2016. Or wait, there was one book I started in 2015, and it was The Magic of Recluse by L.E. Motzit. It's the first book in the Saga of Recluse series, but I didn't finish it, and yeah, it's still on my currently reading shelf. No, I put it back in my wanna read shelf, but I didn't finish it. I plan on reading it at some point because it was a really good book. I really liked what I read of it, but I just couldn't stay away from fanfiction long enough to actually read it. So, going into 2016, I knew I wanted to change my reading habits. I knew I wanted to go back to reading actual books. I started this with, again, listening to audiobooks, and I listened to the Mistborn trilogy by Brandon Sanderson. Or it was a trilogy back then. Now there are more books, 3 more books, but I haven't read them or listened to them yet, so I only listened to the first 3 books. And I really, really enjoyed them. They were also my first foray into high fantasy. Up until that point, I've only read contemporary fantasy, as in Harry Potter or Artemis Fowl. And yeah, I really enjoyed those books, but they didn't really, as they were audiobooks, they didn't really help me get away from fanfiction, because listening to audiobooks wasn't something that cut into my actual reading time. I mainly listened to audiobooks while cleaning or in the bathroom, getting ready, stuff like that. So it didn't actually cut into my reading time. As for books, at the beginning of 2016, I also started reading a book. And it was A Game of Thrones by George R.R. Martin, the first book in the A Song of Fire and Ice series. Or is it A Song of Ice and Fire? I'm sorry, I don't remember the correct way. And I started this because I'd seen the series and I really, really loved the series. And obviously the books are supposed to be very good. So I decided to start it and it was really good, but I only got about halfway through it. I read the book up until summer of 2016 and then I decided to put it back in my want to read shelf because I didn't actually read. Sometimes I would read a couple of pages and then go back to fan fiction and then maybe a month later I would read another couple of pages, but I just couldn't stick with it, so I decided put it back on my want to read shelf and get away from fanfiction first. So during like springtime of 2016, I started listening to podcasts instead of audiobooks. And one of the main podcasts I listened to is Hypebooks Book Hype. And as you can tell by the name, or maybe you know the podcast, they talk about books. So obviously my TBR list kept growing. Also, this kind of introduced me to YA for the first time. A lot of the books they talk about are YA, and so most of the books I put on my TBR list were YA fantasy, be it high fantasy or contemporary fantasy. So my resolve to actually start reading grew, but I still couldn't get away from my fanfiction. Also, my best friend and my little sister both read a lot. They both love Harry Potter, but they read actual books instead of fanfiction, and both of them mainly read YA. YA fantasy, to be exact. So of course, like, pressure came from all sides to actually start reading books. So I started a new book in August of 2016 and it was Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children. I started this book because the book series is one of the favorite series of my best friend, and also in, I think, November? I'm pretty sure it was November of this year, the Miss Peregrine's movie came to the cinemas, so we planned to watch it, especially since my best friend is a huge Tim Burton fan. So I decided I had to read the book before watching the movie. This time not getting into the book, again, obviously was mainly the fault of my reading fanfiction, but also because I just didn't really connect with the book. But by the beginning of October, I had finally finished this book, and October until like the middle of November was kind of a transitioning period for me. During that time, like 1.5 months, I hardly read any fan fiction because I really, really wanted to be good and read actual books, but I hardly read any books either because I just kind of didn't really get into the books I read. So the first book I started reading, and it is still on my current reading shelf in Bookreads, is City of Hollows, again by Ransom Riggs. It's the second book in the Miss Peregrine series, and as I said, I didn't really get into the first book, and the second book it wasn't for me. I know there's so many people out there who love the Miss Peregrine series, but I couldn't get into it, and I still want to finish this book because I do not like not finishing a series or a book unless it's like really, really bad. But it's just, I'm not really that interested in it, but I'm going to finish it at some point, hopefully in 2017. Let's make that one of my reading resolutions. I have to finish City of Hollows in 2017. The second book I read in October was Harry Potter and the Cursed Child. I already got this in July. It was July. The weekend it got out, or I only read it like the weekend after because I was away from home during the week after it came out, but I had already ordered it on Amazon, so when I came home Friday evening, it was already waiting for me. And I read it on that Friday evening, I got about 3/4 through it and then just never picked it up again, yeah, because obviously I didn't really like it much, but it's Harry Potter, so I always felt like I had to read it, and my best friend kept bugging me to read it. She was always like, you have to finish it, just finish it, whatever. And so in October I decided to pick it up again and finally finish it. And I did, and I still didn't like it much. I'm not gonna talk too much about it because I think I'm gonna do a Harry Potter video in general, and you obviously all know what this is about, and everyone has their own opinion. A lot of people like it, a lot of people don't like it. So the third and final book I read during that time was Three Dark Crowns by Kendall Blake. As for this book, I'm not on the fence about it. I loved it and I'm really, really excited for the second book. But it was the wrong book for me to read at the time because I felt like 3/4 of the book was just a prologue. That's at least what I felt to me. It was really interesting, but it was very boring at the same time. I think all the information that was given was very interesting. I really wanted to know more about the characters, about the world, and about the plot. But to me, it just felt like the plot didn't really pick up until the last 50 pages or something. So yeah, it was really hard for me to read because I wasn't that much into reading then, and it just, nothing was happening. It was really weird for me. But then the last couple of pages, the plot really picked up, it got really interesting, and yeah, I really, really loved the book. I think I gave it 4 out of 5 stars, and as I said, I can't wait for the next one. During the middle of November, I found the book that actually, or the book series that actually kept me reading, that actually kept me away from fanfiction. The series I'm talking about is the Mortal Instruments series by Cassandra Clare. Don't be surprised, again, those are my sister's books, they're in German. I did read them on my Kindle and in English, but I decided for the sake of this video to borrow those books from my little sister so I can show them to you. I started obviously with City of Bones, and during the course of those 2 weeks of November and December, I read all of the 6 books, and yeah, that's pretty much it. That's how I got away from fanfiction. I think this series was the perfect series for me to get away from fanfiction at the time. I really, really loved it. I'm not gonna go into the series as with Harry Potter. You probably all know about the series, and maybe I'm gonna do a video on it. There are 6 books in the series, which was perfect for me because if it was just one book, maybe once I've read the book and I didn't find an equally good book right away, I might have gone back to fanfiction, but it was as it was a series, I kind of already had the next book I could read and so on, and yeah, I really, really enjoyed the series. I think also what was good for me was that it was contemporary fantasy, just like Harry Potter, so it was at least the same genre. I think of the books, the last one was my favorite, but I'm not exactly sure, or I don't really wanna make that decision and decide what was my favorite book, at least not after having read them only once. But so far, I think City of Heavenly Fire might really be my favorite. But I don't really want to say it is, but I think it might be. Also, I listened to 2 audiobooks during that time. The first one was A Throne of Glass, and the second one was A Crown of Midnight by Sarah J. Maas. The first and the second books in the Throne of Glass series. I also really enjoyed both those books, and I'm currently listening to Queen of Shadows, so I've already listened to Air of Fire as well, but I'm gonna talk about that one in my January wrap up because I listened to it in January. January, that's a really hard word for me to say, let's just ignore it, whatever. This is my December wrap up and my 2016 or whatever reading story, so yeah, I'm finished with my December wrap-up as well as with my reading story. I hope you liked this video. If there was a book you were interested in, I'll list all the books I mentioned in the down bar, as well as the links to their Goodreads pages, so you can just check them out. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up, leave me a comment, or even subscribe to me on YouTube. I also have a list of all my social media links down below. Bye!